Hi, my name is Priyanka, and this is my project titled Comparative Analysis of the Performance of Various Error Correction Techniques Across a Noisy Channel for the course Wireless Communications at the University of Florida. Let's begin with discussing a little about error correction techniques. When the data is transmitted from one system to another, it passes through a channel which may end up adding noise and consequently errors to the original data. This causes unreliability in the data transmission. These error correcting codes were developed to detect and, if possible, correct the error so the original data during the transmission can be retained. The error correction methods. There are different kinds of error correction methods. They are automatic repeat request, error correcting codes, and hybrid schemes. For this project, we are concentrating on the error correcting codes. There are many different kinds of error correcting codes. They come in a variety of different shapes, sizes, suited for different applications. The error correcting codes that are selected for this project are Reed-Solomon codes, low-density parity check code, turbo code, Hamming code, Golay code, and cyclic redundancy check code. The original aim of this project was only to compare the Reed-Solomon, the low-density parity check, and the turbo codes. But due to the early completion of the project and availability of excess time, I decided to go forward and compare all the other codes as well. Now let's move on to the Reed-Solomon codes. The Reed-Solomon codes use mbit symbols instead of bits. They are written as RS of n, k with s bit symbols. The input data to the Reed-Solomon codes should be in the form of k column Galois array. This is the typical code word of the Reed-Solomon code. It is referred to as a systematic code as the data in the left is left unchanged. The parity bits in this case are appended. The total code word is donated by n and it is a sum of the k bits and the 2t parity bits. This is the RS system. The system consists of an RS encoder, a noisy channel, and a decoder. The input data passes through the encoder where the parity bits are added to it and sent to the decoder through the noisy channel, which incorporates the errors. The decoder decodes the bits and detects the error location. Now moving on to low-density parity check code or the LDPC code. They get their name from the characteristic parity check matrix that contains fewer ones than compared to zeros. The LDPC codes are classified as linear error correcting codes. They employ sparse parity check matrices and long block lengths. These long block lengths are used to attain near Shannon limit performance. This is the system that I simulated using Simulink. The input from the Bernoulli binary generator goes into the LDPC encoder where it is appended with a carry. Then it goes to the modulator as the LDPC requires its inputs to be in the form of the log likelihood ratios. Then passing to the noisy channel which incorporates the errors, it goes to the demodulator. And then from the demodulator, it goes to the decoder. From the decoder, the original input and the decoded input are compared using the error rate calculation. The output from the error rate calculation goes to the command window from where it is incorporated into the code. Now moving on to turbo codes or parallel concatenated convolution coding. There are examples of first-class turbo codes. They belong to the category of high-performance FEC or forward error correction codes. These codes were a practical approach to reach the channel capacity, also called as the Shannon limit. This is a simulated diagram of the turbo code. This was done using Simulink. The random input generated from the Bernoulli block is given to the encoder, which then acts as an input to the noisy channel after passing through the unipolar to bipolar converter. This output then goes to the decoder, and from there it goes to the PER measurement block, and from there it goes to the command window, which incorporates the PER values into the code to find the SNR versus PER graphs. Now let's look a bit deeper into the Hamming codes. The Hamming codes are characterized under linear error correcting codes. They are also known as perfect codes and contain a parity check matrix. The input is first converted into the binary format. Then, the bits which only have one bit in their binary form are considered to be the parity bits and the other bits are considered as the data bits. Each data bit is then involved in a unique set consisting of two or higher parity bits and the data bit. The parity bits are checked for errors and the sum of the location of the parity bits indicate the errors. Now moving on to Golay codes. Golay codes are similar to the Hamming codes. Golay codes are characterized as perfect linear error correcting codes. There are two different versions of this code, namely the binary Golay codes and the ternary Golay codes. In the binary Golay structure, a code word is formed by taking inputs and concatenating them with the check bits. The information bits are broken into pieces and encoded together into the single code word. The decoder receives these values and locates the errors using the parity bits. It computes the check bits of the code word and checks for its value. If it is zero, then it indicates no errors. And if it is non-zero, then it indicates the errors. Then these errors are eliminated by rotating them cyclically and toggling it. Now the CRC or the cyclic redundancy check. It is an error controlling method which is employed to detect and correct errors during message transmission. They create extra bits called as syndromes, as in the case of Golay codes. They are concatenated with the message word. And similar to the Golay codes, if the syndrome is zero, then there is no error. And if it is not zero, then that indicates that there is an error present in it. After the error is detected, it asks the sender to resend the message word, as the CRC do not have the function of built-in error correction. Now, moving on to BER versus SNR graphs. To analyze and make a comparative analysis of all the techniques, BER versus SNR graphs were used along with the error rate and number of errors rectified. Now, I'm going to give a demo of my MATLAB codes. This is the MATLAB code written for the Reed-Solomon code. If I run it, I'm going to get the number of errors which were rectified and the BER versus SNR graph. The error rate in this case was 0.0921 and the number of errors rectified were 55. Now moving on to turbo codes. As you'll see, turbo codes are a little more complex and take a little more time than the RS codes to compute. The number of errors are 274 which were rectified and the error rate is 0.13. This is the BER versus SNR graph for the turbo code. Moving on to the Hamming codes. The Hamming codes are similar to the RS codes and they are also known as perfect codes. Now as you can see, the errors are being detected and reduced. So now they have been reduced to 3 errors. The 3 errors could not be rectified. Now these are, and now this is the SNR versus the BER versus SNR graph. Moving on to Golay codes. Golay codes is also similar to Hamming codes, and this is the SNR versus the BER graph for the Golay encoder. The CRC, in the case of the CRC, to check if it is working or not, I have given two inputs. One is the original input which is without the error, and one is the input which contains the error. So as you can see, it has identified that the first input has no errors and hence it's given 0 as the output. And it has identified that the second input has the errors and hence it is given 1, indicating that there is an error present. Now, the LDPC also takes a little more time to compute than the other codes, as it is a little more complex. The number of errors was 0. It identified the errors and rectified them, and this is the SNR versus BER graph. Now, from all this, we can go to our observations. We have observed that the RS codes give very good performance, but all the errors are not detected and corrected. They seem to be giving better performance than the LDPC in the BER versus SNR graph, but only for a certain set of parameters. The Golay and the Hamming codes provide similar performance to the RS codes. As we saw in our demonstration, the Golay codes could not rectify all the errors. They give perfect outputs, but for a very limited range of values. The LDPC and turbo codes give us very high coding gains. The coding gain difference between these two codes is 0.5 dB. From the simulations, we saw that the turbo codes outperform the LDPC codes when the data is only 200 bits. It is also observed in the simulations that for data lengths which are less than 800 bits, the turbo codes perform better than LDPC. And for the data lengths which are greater than 8000, the LDPC is better than the turbo codes. Some may prefer LDPC over the turbo codes due to their lower decoding complexity. Nevertheless, it is very difficult to predict which code will perform better when the frame size is between 800 bits to 8000 bits. The simulation was done using Simulink, and this was a simulation the model which was created for the turbo codes. As you can see, if I run it, I will get 3 values. The first one is my BER. This BER is going to the command window from where it goes to the code where it is used for creating the SNR versus the BER graph. This is the second simulation, which is for the LDPC code. And as shown in the, as explained before, the LDPC code will generate a BER, which is then sent to the command window, which incorporates it into the code. Now, for conclusion, all the selected codes were simulated and the results were obtained. In the cases where the BER could not be obtained directly from the code, the model was created in Simulink, like the turbo codes and the LDPC codes, and it was simulated for various values of SNR, and the outputs were then sent to the command window where it was incorporated into the code. There is always an obvious trade-off between redundancy in hardware and performance, for example, the interleavers. Concluding the best or the worst technique is foolish, as all the techniques are widely used and each technique is best for its own scenario. While even turbo codes may underperform in certain scenarios, the RS codes would outshine it in those cases and vice versa. The performance depends on various factors like the number of iterations, number of bits, etc. The best coding scheme would be selected according to the scenario. Only then will the best results be obtained. Thank you.